Hi, I'm Curt Edelmann with the Franklin Fire Department. I'd like to talk to you, food vendors especially, about fire department regulations for operating food trucks and mobile food vendor sites at our festivals. All right, when you're first setting up your mobile food vending operation, take a look at the site. One of the problems we've had is that sometimes the sites are too close to pedestrians and things like that. We want to make sure that the people walking around are going to maintain a safe distance from your cooking operation. So check out your site. If you feel that it's a little too close, that the general public might be too close to your cooking operation, work with your event sponsor to relocate your tent or your setup or to adjust it a little bit so that we can keep the public away from your cooking operations. Event sponsors work hard to make sure that the vendors and the food trucks are properly located, but they can't catch everything. So we ask food vendors that when they pull up to kind of check their sites. And one of the things that's been a real problem is with the exhaust hoods on top of the vehicles. We want to make sure that they're not up in any trees or any other obstructions like that. So when you spot your boot or when you spot your food truck, check it out. And if there's a problem with the location, your vent doesn't vent properly or something, get one of the event sponsors to try to move your location or adjust it so that your exhaust fan isn't infringing on any trees or overhanging obstructions. When we're doing inspections at special events with the food vendors, a lot of food vendors struggle with the proper extinguishers that they need to have. So what I'm hoping to do is just take a couple minutes to show you all the different kinds of extinguishers and show you which ones you need to have, so it won't be an issue when it comes time for your inspection. Okay, all cooking vendors are required to have what's called a Class ABC fire extinguisher. This is an all-purpose fire extinguisher. It's meant to work on most types of fires. And this one is actually a little bit bigger than the one you're required to have. What you should be looking for is you want an extinguisher that has at least a 2A rating. This is the all-purpose fire extinguishers. When you have a fire extinguisher for an event in Franklin, we require that it be tagged by a licensed fire equipment dealer. And if you're from out of state, that's fine. As long as you have your state's tag on the extinguisher, we'll accept that. Another thing we check is the overall condition of the extinguisher, make sure it doesn't look too beat up. But a big thing that we check is the pressure. We want to make sure that the extinguisher has enough pressure to operate. So that's basically the Class ABC fire extinguisher. If you have a frying operation, you're required to have what's called a Class K extinguisher. Class K extinguishers are intended to be used specifically on deep fryers and grease type fires. It contains a special potassium agent in there that helps extinguish the fire. Again, we want to make sure that it has a tag on it. If it's out of state, that's fine, as long as we can tell it's a valid tag. And we want to make sure that the gauge is in the normal reading. And just, like I said, we take a general look at the condition of the fire extinguisher. Now, if you have a solid fuel cooking operation, if you're using wood, if you're using charcoal, the fire code requires that you have a water extinguisher. And this is an example of a water extinguisher. It's a 2.5 gallon water extinguisher. Again, it's tagged, it has a gauge. If you have a solid fuel cooking operation and you're also frying, the Class K will cover both. It will cover both your frying operations and your solid fuel operation, because essentially the agent in here is mostly water. But if you don't have a frying operation, if you just have a wood-burning pizza oven or you're grilling with charcoal or something like that, then you need to have a 2.5 gallon water extinguisher. And I wanted to make this clear because the Class K extinguisher is twice as much as the 2.5 gallon water extinguisher. And I know of a lot of vendors who've gotten thinking that the Class K would work, went out and bought the the Class K extinguisher instead of just buying the water extinguisher. Now, I cannot recommend vendors, but if you go online, look for fire extinguishers or fire equipment dealers, shop around a little bit and you'll probably get a good price. Okay, that's basically all I have. If you have any other questions, please call the fire department, 615-791-3270. Thank you very much.